students is breaking the heart.
That is for the teacher. That's not for the merits for each other. For the merits for each other, they have to be aware and be awake. They don't just say anything. They don't just do anything. That is going to be depending on how close you are to the person, how you are understanding that one, how that one is understanding you. The sheikh can use any method, especially Naqshbandi sheikhs. They can praise you, they can boost you, they can say something, they cannot say something, they can knock you wall to wall. Whatever means necessary to bring you to paradise, they will. They are given the full license. If it's talk nice, they can curse at you. Because behind all of that is the love that they have for you. Behind all of that is the concern. They cry for you, thinking, how am I going to fix this? How this one is going to now get fixed? How this one is going to... They are busy with that. They're not busy with themselves. Their family and their loved ones behind. They say, this one has some issue. How am I going to fix it? Ya Rabbi, praying constantly for that one, trying to find a way. So, who are the shaykhs? Or the teacher? The teacher has to make the merits to understand what is in their heart. If their heart is filled with stuff that is no good, you have to take it out. If it's taken over your whole heart, now they're going to, depending how it is, then you have to smash it. They have to, meaning you have to change so many things. Depends what kind of merit. Depends on your closeness, depends on your ambition, spiritual ambition, your aim, depends on your responsibility. We're not forcing people, we're not telling people you have to come, you have to live like this. And no, each according to their willingness, said, okay, now you're coming closer a little bit. You come closer, these are the things you have to do. You come closer, these are the things you have to do. You're a bit far away, well, these are the things you have to do. You're far away, but your heart is close, this is what you have to do. So everything, now it is tailored, custom fit, you understand? There's more work, there's more trouble. But for the real sheikh, or our sheikh, it's not a trouble at all. This is how a sheikh is going to be. It's not going to cut everyone down to the same size. But for the merits for each other, they should try to be careful. And at the same time, our sheikh is also saying, don't say to each other, oh, you shouldn't have said that, you broke my heart. It's forbidden for me to say that. Now, you see how the shaykhs, they work? They put one thing and then they take it out. They say one thing and then they say something that's opposite. But it's supposed to make sense. Those who are intelligent, you're going to understand. Just as nobody sees there's anything contradictory, something hot. Is there anything contradictory there? You're still using your breath, correct? But one is to warm and one is to cool down. Now, only somebody who is not thinking properly is going to say, how can you use the same action, two different results? How you can do that? How can two different results come from one action? So, it can, it makes sense. I don't have to explain to you. It is the intention and it is also the execution of it. It's completely different. Just from the outside, it looks like it's the same. So they may say things that are contradictory, but if you look at it, it's not. It fits to this time. This one doesn't fit to that. This one fits to this person. It doesn't fit to that person. The whole problem is when people are crushing into each other's orbits. You have your own orbit to split. Just like the planets, just like the atoms. You have your own orbit. Spin in your own orbit. Who has a right now to tell you, oh, you're crushing to the one who is the creator of the orbit? The sheikh is there. Now he's saying, now don't interfere so much into that one. You don't behave like this because you're interfering with this. If everyone is now spinning in their own orbits very nicely, it is a very beautiful sight to see. everything is moving around. There is, as if there is no control. But there's so much power and everyone is knowing how to move. So, if it's necessary, as the Shaykh is going to break your heart, what does that mean? Your heart has wrong things that is going to pull you into hellfire. You're going to get into trouble. And you see, even when your heart is diseased, what do the doctors do? They throw it out. They put a new one in. Your heart is diseased, what do? They pat you on the back, they try to talk to you, or they cut it off. The doctors of the heart, when it's necessary, they're going to do that. Don't ask for it. It's not easy. That is the last resort. If people are intelligent enough, they should know, they should find out, and by themselves, they should try to fix. You understand? Inshallah. But no, you're not going to be just to each other, just to be idiots to each other. Break each other's hearts, say things. Especially in our jamaat, we're not going to do things like, oh, why are you doing that to me? Ah, I'm a test from your sheikh to you.
Yeah, I was telling my wife about that.
No, you cannot do that, especially not in our jamaat. The sheikh can say, of course, the murids are there for each other, the sheikh may place certain things, but the murid itself is not going to say, why are you getting upset with me? They go up to you, they punch you in the face, you look at them and say, ah, my sheikh is sending me to test your patience. Because don't you know that story? No. That is very wrong understanding, very lazy understanding. Inshallah, step by step. Come on, anything else?